morning.
Live. Usually we call you before, and then we just the intro started in lock. Was like I forgot to call them.
running start.
Yeah, the intro started, and I'm like, we need to call them. How you doing, brother?
I'm doing well, my friend. You guys?
Good.
Pretty decent.
I don't want to start off on a downer, but Dale Hawerchuk, we lost him yesterday. He succumbed to his battle with stomach cancer. And the thing I remember, because I was a Winnipeg guy for a bit, I worked at a rock station there for about 6 years. And man, that city loved that guy. He was a hero, man, like a local legend, right? And I thought it would be an interesting conversation, because you've met more hockey players than we have, I think. Who's the nicest hockey player you've met?
Well, first of all, I mean, you're 100% right about Dale Hawerchuk. I mean, looking around the reaction from hockey Twitter yesterday, you could tell how much he meant to the city and the hockey community at large. So, sad news yesterday, unfortunately.
Yeah.
To 57. See him lose his battle with... Yeah, 57 is way too young, so...
Yeah.
Heck of a career, one of the best that ever did it. Plenty of props to Dale Hawerchuk on a fine career, and by all accounts, he seemed like a very nice man. But to answer your question, the nicest hockey player I've ever met was Ryan Smith. He was just as nice as everyone ever hopes he was. I got to do we went to Moose Jaw to cover his retirement ceremony with the Moose Jaw Warriors, and somehow I weaseled my way into a box that he was in.
Oh, nice.
And I got introduced to him, and he signed a couple of things for me, chatted a couple minutes about what it's like to blog about hockey. He was just very, very nice. He was one of those guys that he spent a couple minutes talking to me when he very clearly did not have to. So that's always kind of what I think about. He's the guy that everybody always hoped he was.
You know, in the world of sports, quite often we focus on the douchebags, right? They seem to get more press. So that's why I wanted to talk about, because I remember that being in Winnipeg. I mean, there were a couple people in the sports world that were propped up on pedestals, and Dale was one of those guys. And again, I said this morning, you will not find anybody. There is nobody walking around today that goes, yeah, but everyone loved that man. He was just a good guy, right?
Yeah, I was happy. I got to go to Winnipeg for the Heritage Classic a couple years ago, and it was just fun seeing how much the people in Winnipeg really appreciated watching Hawerchuk in the Legends game that happened before. That was a lot of fun to watch him do his thing, even though, you know, those guys are all older now, which is the point of it, I guess. But yeah, people in Winnipeg loved him. Yeah, I remember when he got announced, he got a massive ovation from the crowd, and you know, it makes sense.
Yeah.
So as everyone in Edmonton tries to figure out what's wrong with the Oilers, and everyone has an opinion, one of the conversations I keep hearing is that they need better goaltending. And I was just thinking about watching Vegas last night. And could you see them taking a run at, like, Marc-Andre Fleury?
Yeah, or Lehner, to be honest. He needs a contract as well. It's just a matter of... The problem the Oilers have is they definitely need a goaltending upgrade. No offense to Mikko Koskinen. I think he can be fine with somebody else. But the problem is they just don't have very much money available to spend. With a flat cap, it really hurts the Oilers. But they're not alone with that. So, I mean... There's probably 10, 12 teams that are going to be, whoa, when it terms of spending dollars because they don't have any room. So it's going to be interesting to see what some of these goalies actually sign for, because everybody's kind of in the same boat. There's no way all these top-end free agents are going to go to bottom feeder teams that have cap space just because they can make a little bit extra money. So it's going to be an interesting offseason, because I think there's going to be some deals to be had that would never normally happen. Even a guy like Taylor Hall, he's a free agent this year. I wouldn't be surprised if a guy like that, who would have been set for a massive payday had it not been for the pandemic, that maybe he signs a one-year deal here and there to try and win something and get his value up, because, you know, he's already made something like $40 million or whatever. He'll be fine no matter what. So it's going to be interesting to see what happens with these guys. Not a lot of teams have money. Not a lot of teams have space to do anything, but they all need upgrades. So Oilers are no different. I'd like to see Robin Lehner. I think Thomas Greiss is an option that'll be kind of floated around the city until free agency kicks off, but we'll have to see how it goes, because Ken Holland's going to have to clear some space to make it happen.
Speaking of douchebags, Thank you for bringing that up. By the way, didn't they talk about a cap increase this year, or did that get killed because of COVID?
Yeah, it was supposed to. It was supposed to be a sizable jump in the cap. So yeah, you're 1,000% right. And then because of COVID and the shutdown for 4 months, no fans, the TV deal getting rearranged or whatever happened, yeah. They basically have said it's going to be flat for the next three seasons. Okay. So it's going to be interesting to see. There's a lot of teams that are going to be hurting from it, Oilers included, and it's going to be interesting to see how Ken Holland navigates these tricky budget times.
Yeah, because it's that actually is probably the bigger part of the problem right now moving forward for the Oilers, is that I think they were planning, they were signing and putting people on paper based on the possibility of this cap, right?
Well, that's
so,
exactly it.
So they screwed themselves. So that means they could trade somebody away here, right? Like to make room. Yeah.
They're going to have to. Even in Ken Holland's year-end availability, it was just a Zoom call or whatever, he talks about a guy like Andreas Athanasiou, who's up for a new contract. He had a bad year. He had a very, very bad year. But Ken Holland talked about, well, when we traded for him at the deadline, we kind of walked into that trade thinking that the cap was going to be, you know, around $85-86 million, and now it's going to be 81.5. Well, that's a big problem. So a lot of GMs kind of had plans going forward that, like you said, the cap was supposed to go up, and then, yeah, you know, the old global pandemic got in the way.
I know you're not that excited about anybody winning the cup, but is there a team right now that you've been watching over the last little while, we'll wrap up with this, that you're like watching going, wow, look at that?
Unfortunately, we've been doing we've been talking about this on a real life podcast. We're doing a lot of hate watching, to be honest.
Yeah.
So I got to say, I'm cheering for the Columbus Blue Jackets. If they can knock out the Tampa Bay Lightning 2 years in a row, I think that's incredible. I also, I think it's fun watching Montreal do what they're doing, although Philly's come roaring back over the last couple of games. But I think it's kind of fun to watch some of the underdog teams do something. But if I had to pick a horse, I'm going on Columbus. I think they're fun to watch. They work hard. I like the way John Tortorella yelled at him. It entertains me. Like, I don't know. There's something there.
Yeah. I'm going with the Avalanche.
I like the Islanders.
Nathan MacKinnon, man.
The Avs look good, too, though.
Yeah.
The Avalanche are a great team. And, like, Nathan MacKinnon is just a freak. And
like, he ragdolled that guy the other night, too, in the fight. Like,
oh. He's lightning fast. He's got great hands. He's a great hockey player. So I love the Colorado pick as well. They're a lot of fun to watch. And you look at that team and go, wow, man, they've really got a chance to do something here.
All right. Well, we'll let you go. Thank you for your time today, Baggedmilk.
Thanks, boys.
Baggedmilk from Oilers Nation. As always, we hit him up on Wednesday.